First off, apologies for the video quality. It's only 480, but it'll work for what we're doing here. This one, we're going to look at Auston Matthews' release and one of the techniques he's using in his release. I always talk about having a good shot selection and not just one or two shots that you can use. So like last night I watched all 40 of Matthews' goals from last year, and you know, there's very few. I don't think I could find more than three or four that are from the same area, the same type of shot. So that's why it's important to have a shot selection, be able to shoot off of both feet, off a forehand and backhand, all types of different ways to release the puck around your body. So this one we're going to touch on is two-touch or area shooting. So it's when you actually put a puck into an area and thrust onto it or step over top of it and shoot without handling. So there's about three or four examples here we'll go through and just let them run. So this one's a backhand where he fishes it out of a scrum and kind of pulls it into an area and then just steps forward onto it for a quick release. So off his skate to an area, and from that area he just steps onto it without handling. This one's a forehand where it's a knockdown and then a release. So he knocks it from the backhand into an area and then just steps forward through it really quick. This one is a amazingly fast release. You can't even really see it unless you slow it down to a quarter speed there. So this is a little bit different. It's a catch on the backhand to an area and then a release. This is more of a thrust shot. Daryl Belfry talks about this one. It's when you don't really transfer any weight laterally across your body. So his toes are pointing at the net, and it's just a thrust. The hands come away from the body, top hand pulls back, and bottom hand goes out, almost using the stick like a lever. But you see the thrust at the waist. A lot of the power on that shot comes from thrusting at the waist and kicking that back foot out. So you can generate power just within your body without transferring weight across your body. Here's the one that stood out to me the other night, the Montreal goal. Just being able to knock this pass down into an area and release it instantly. Not having to handle that puck is a really good way to just buy yourself some space and time with the goalie. If he would have caught that puck and even did one stick handle in there, there's no way he would have got that goal. Price would have been over and set. But the fact that he knocked it down off of the pass and then just shot it without handling it or corralling it, that was what generally created that goal, was the speed of the release and the goalie not being set and ready. So here's a couple things we do working on it. So this one is forehand to backhand. So the player is just going to get that puck, pull it from his forehand to backhand, step onto it and shoot. And as you'll see here, what this player does is mimics that two-touch. So he's got it on the inside of the obstacle, pulls it out through, and shoots it from that area. As the puck is sliding, still off of his initial pull through the obstacle, he shoots it without handling it. Next player, you'll see the difference. So the next player comes up, pulls that puck from inside to outside, and handles it two times before shooting it. So just that extra handle in there. So pulls it through, rather than shooting from right there. And you can see he's not even set up to do it. He didn't rotate at the trunk. He didn't unhinge his upper body from lower body to generate a twisting power to get, or a twisting motion to generate power. He's still got the puck in front of him. So he's got the puck in front of him, has a stick handle it a couple times, and then really doesn't get much on the shot, and it's goalie would have been over and set to compared to the first shooter. Here's another one. Double stick handle, just slows it down compared to the first player. So then we switched. Now they're pulling it from the inside on their backhand to the outside. And what this player does here, you can see the speed of pulling it through and stepping down onto it. So he's got it on his outside foot, the weight is there, and as that puck comes through, he transfers his weight across to the inside foot and just shoots directly from there. So that shot is off of the inside foot, which makes it just one weight transfer. This player, you can see, he pulls it through, and he's only been taught to shoot off of his outside foot the way that we're taught when we're a novice and Adam, and you know, when we're first developing our shot. But you can see here, in comparison to the first player, that first player pulled it through and shot right there off of that step, where this player hasn't been taught to shoot off of that foot, so he has to hold on to the puck, wait, transfer his weight to his other foot, and then shoot from there. So you can see the speed difference of shooting off of that inside foot versus the players that have to hold it and can only shoot off of their outside foot. So again, this is the shot we all learn when we first start playing hockey, but having a shot selection and being able to have more than one tool in the toolbox is crucial for young players. And you can just see by these videos the speed of the release that Matthews uses. Even though all of his goals don't come off of the inside foot, it doesn't matter which foot you shoot off of, as long as it's in stride and quick. So just by this last example here, it really, really puts home the point of the release could have came from right there versus all the way down here. It's an extra, you know, fractions or a good portion of a second that player has to hold on to that puck where a goalie can come across and get set. So I hope this makes sense and helps you understand the release a little bit more.